So, Jim, I love the concept. And by the way, do you have a favorite basketball team?
Well, I kind of like Duke.
Do you? Yeah. That's a wise decision. Yeah, and I like Duke, West Virginia, Stanford. But it is interesting to watch how quickly this has changed. Help me bring to life what we just talked about. All and right, if John. You will, talk about what we're announcing today and what does it really mean to the future of where we think the TV experience is going to go.
Well, this really, as you said, it really is about the experience. So why don't we step into my living room over here, and we'll give you an example of some of the capabilities that the new Videoscape experience provides.
Now, your living room's coming up quality-wise. You aren't spending a little bit too much money on expenses lately, are you?
You like my furniture here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, in my living room here, we have one of our latest generation of Videoscape set-top boxes. We've got the Videoscape Media Gateway, which we'll show you in just a moment here. Yep. And, of course, we have the Yumi telepresence. And we're working with all of these together. This is part of the Yumi telepresence that we announced earlier in this year. And so this is all integrated through the Videoscape architecture. So for example, if I want, I can bring up my Yumi telepresence, and I have the ability to make videos. I can share them with my family. I can share them with YouTube. Or I can simply call and have a high-definition video experience. As a matter of fact, there's your cousin, Ken. Looks like
he's from West Virginia, by the way. I don't know if I told
calling.
You that.
Let's go ahead and see what cousin Ken has to say. Hi, Ken.
Hi, Ken.
Well,
how you doing?
Hello, Jim. It's nice to see you. And cousin John.
I see you've got your West Virginia colors on, blue and gold.
Yes, I do. I got a Snuggie. I got a Snuggie for Christmas. John sent me this. I can't believe it. You know, a blanket with sleeves.
Yeah.
Who would have thought of that? I mean, really. I like the fact that it's now a Cisco company. That's pretty good. You guys are into everything.
I think maybe you're reading that wrong, Ken.
Oh,
is that
right?
Anyway,
I'm not sure. And I love the Yumi too, John. Thanks for that. That was a great gift. It was so generous. I hope you didn't have to pay full sticker.
No, I got a discount being a company employee. We did well on that.
Oh, that's a happy thing.
And West Virginia's looking good this year in basketball, but I still don't think they'll get past Duke. I think they'll get beat again like they did last year.
I don't know about that. Yes, this is a special Snuggie I got right here. I mean, they did. Okay, I'll give it to you. Duke did take West Virginia in NCAA last year, but we call that a Duke fluke. Yeah, and if you want to learn a little bit about basketball, so we can have an intelligent discussion on the subject, I recommend you go look around television, see if you can find some basketball games. Then you get back to me and we can talk.
Ken, that's what I will do. Now, obviously, what we're doing here is talking about the quality of experience. The eye contact, I can see cousin Ken needs a little bit of a shave.
No, actually, I grew that special for this press event.
Okay, well, you did well. And you get to feel the interaction that occurs with the quality and the ease of use.
That's right. I got it, Jim.
All
right, Ken, well, thanks a lot for helping us with the demo today. We appreciate
it. Always a pleasure.
Okay.
Happy New Year.
All right.
How I'm going to tie together my whole family.
Yeah,
from the parents through the grandkids, the ability to do that on a regular basis. It's got to be easy to use.
Well, let's take Ken's advice and let's search for some basketball content.
Okay.
So what we're going to do here is we're going to browse here. Now, this is my now playing queue and this is my friends feed. So we're getting recommendations from friends and family members. I'm going to browse to sports content. And also, you notice these things all change. So this is about bringing the best content available depending on the category or the type that we're searching on here. And I'm going to click on basketball and bring up some basketball content. Now, you'll notice there's three columns here, John.
Yes.
This is what you would normally be getting from your traditional television provider.
Okay.
And this is including content like this, content that's on now, so a live game, for example, coming from a premium provider like ESPN, for example. I also have potentially DVR content that I've recorded on my set-top. I also might have subscription content where I can get a replay. Here's the All-Star game, and I can get a replay of any of this content. Now, this is what you would normally expect from your television provider as high-quality HD-type content, but this is where it begins to start to get a little bit different. So you'll see that there's a column here of content from providers, and there's a column of content from my network. And the provider content, this is content that you might have gotten from a premium website, from a proprietary over-the-top set-top box.
From our EOS partners.
That's right, from our EOS partners, from any of these different places. But now we're going to bring this content to your living room, to the set. And so, for example, here's some interesting content from an EOS partner.
So that basically was the All-Star game, you know, and really everything that goes behind it as far as getting the stadium ready, et cetera.
That's right. And I'm going to go ahead and we'll go ahead and click and we can watch it now. Of course, this is not HD because it's purpose for the web,
yes,
but that gives us room to provide these new upselling opportunities for our service provider partners so that they have the ability to target advertising to consumers. And of course, with our EOS technology, mm-hmm. this allows us to get very targeted depending on the different consumers.
But you could do the same thing with an entertainment group, like with Paramore, how they maintain contact with their fan base, how you distribute it out,
Absolutely. Et cetera. Absolutely. Now, this is interesting because even though this is premium content that might be available on the web,
yes,
it's also available within my channel lineup. And the Videoscape architecture is smart enough to know that. So when I go to play this content, I have the option of watching it on court style, which is the provider, or mm-hmm. it's available through, in this case, my service provider we've called Earthcom for the demo here, in high quality.
So it brings you to the highest quality that you can get access to.
That's right. It knows I've already paid for this.
Pay once, gain access from any screen, anytime.
That's right. So it's going to bring me the best quality experience possible. And then finally, the last column here, this is content that's coming from my personal network. Mm-hmm. And so this is there's my mom. She uploaded a flip video of my nephew's dog playing in the snow there in Boston.
Oh, I don't miss the snow.
There's another video of some coworkers playing basketball. Mm-hmm. And anytime I want to share video or my family members or friends share video, whether it be from Flipshare or Facebook or YouTube or any of these mm-hmm. Public sharing places, we have the ability to interoperate with that. So, for example, John, let's make a quick video with my flip camera of you, and you can respond to cousin Ken and his basketball enthusiasm.
All right, I'll try to control myself.
Share it.
Hey, Ken, I love the Mountaineers, but I think they're about a year or two away from being in the top 10 again. Great coach, great incoming freshman that I think will play well, but don't bet against Duke this year. I think you're going to lose if you do that.
All right, thank you, John. We'll get a little bit of the fine audience here. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to share this video. So this is where the new Videoscape Media Gateway comes in. And this is a Media Gateway handles voice, data, video, and it gives me the ability to integrate devices, for example, the Flip that has USB, so I can simply plug this into the USB port on the gateway.
But it could also, in the future, be where we will probably go with the Flip as an example in terms of wireless capability. Again, it's a controlled architecture.
That's right. And it handles voice as well. And as you can see, mm-hmm. that video has now showed up right in my network. So if I click here, and we can preview that video, mm-hmm. we can share it. Let's go ahead and preview it.
Sure.
Hey, Ken, I love the Mountaineers, but I think they're about a year or two away from being in the top 10 again. Great coach, great incoming freshman that I think will play well, but don't bet against Duke this year. I think you're going to lose if you do that.
All right. Thank you, John. We'll get a little bit of the audience, the fine audience.
Okay. Now, while this looks fascinating to you, this will be child's play. My two-year-old will be 4 years in 2 years. We'll be able
That's
to
right.
do this basic type of activity.
That's right.
If you go all the way back, we could basically do this all around sports or all around anything we wanted to do, and we could
absolutely.
Actually rate the content as we go.
And we could record with portable devices. We could record with the Yumi, and then we can go back and we can share this with my personal network so that my mother, my friends, my family will be able to see this content.
So if you'd bring us back onto this, we could basically be watching, let's say it's a Duke West Virginia basketball game. We could then see coming in from partners additional replays or specifics from the stadiums, etc. And then we could see from our friends information
That's
going
right.
back and forth. And you could have this tagged in the sense this whole screen would just be about that ball game
That's
if
right.
we wanted it to be.
That's
so
right.
it could either be based upon general time
right.
coming in,
that's
or
exactly
topics.
What it is right now. Because we searched on basketball, everything that's in this content area is based about on basketball.
So now, is that dog rolling the basketball that I missed?
Exactly.
Okay. Just want to show that I'm watching.
Now, John, of course, we want to be able to take this experience with us. So that's great when you're in the living room and on your set-top box. But we also have the Videoscape software clients that mm-hmm. will run literally on just about any device. So this allows the consumer to choose their device. For example, I have an Android device here.
So software on the set-top box interfacing the T is one, but it could be on any device at all.
That's right. I've got an Android device here. Mm-hmm. I'm going to show you the software client here. Now, what's interesting here is you'll notice that my mobile device is syncing, and it knows what we were doing last, which was searching on basketball.
Yes.
So we're getting that premium content. We get that on my mobile device. We're also getting the partner content that we saw. And we also get my personal network here. Mm-hmm. So you can see that flip video is there. Oh, looks like Cousin Ken has tweeted, and he's uploaded a new piece of video content.
Okay.
Now, I want you to notice, not only am I getting that update on my mobile device here, but I'm also getting it on, notice the top right of the set-top box, there's that video Cousin Ken. So
okay.
It keeps all the devices in sync. And if I click here.
We got to see this because he's got his West Virginia colors on. He's got
right.
a basketball.
I'm going to click here to view.
Okay.
Duke's going down, just like this ball. In your face, Cousin John. Mm. Can I get you a little help here?
Well, Cousin Ken's a little creative with his video
he
sharing.
He is a little hung out.
I don't know who took this flip video. But in any case, you get the idea that we get the content. And it doesn't matter what device. It can be a gaming box, gaming platforms, Android device like this.
Here's so any content from any device, managed or unmanaged networks, managed or unmanaged devices, much like
right.
the internet in
that's
concept.
Right. Here's an iPad.
Yep.
So here's the software client running on an iPad.
Yes.
So of course we have much more screen real estate here on the iPad, and this gives us the ability to give us a much richer environment. I can choose that same Hoop It Up video that we were watching, and I even have the ability to interact with it here. So if I want to buy that jersey, I can just click here.
And that's where back at the service provider cloud, you're really talking about the capability to manage these type of
that's
activities,
right.
what device we're going to screen-wise, et cetera.
That's right. I'm just putting my PIN in, and mm-hmm. it'll charge it right to my existing television provider account.
Oh, I like that. Thank you for getting me that jersey.
Oh, you're welcome, John. All right.
Okay.
Now, all of this technology, it really looks easy here, but it really takes a considerable amount of technology back in the network, in the cloud, and on the endpoints. And I brought a diagram just to illustrate this.
It's self-explanatory.
It is self-explanatory if you look very closely.
But you know, I've asked Jim on every time we do a demo, it's so easy to put up some nice slideware and put concepts like how the cloud and the network and the devices play together. It is hard to make work. And as you begin to think about merely saying who's getting access, do they have proper authentication to be able to do it?
That's right.
If you think about what networks you're going across, what devices are there, mm-hmm. what is the wireless capacity inside the stadium versus inside your home capability, the ability to then tag and search off of this, it really
that's
requires
right.
an architecture to do
and
this. You can't do it with individual pieces.
That's right, and keep track of what you're doing. So the conductor back in the network knows what you were last doing. If you were watching a movie and you move from the living room to a mobile device, the movie picks up where you left off or vice versa.
It just orchestrates this for
that's
us,
right.
in essence.
That's right. So all of these components.
And tell me what
and
goes
then,
back on in the cloud.
And then,
I mean,
well, that's where we also have the Videoscape Media Suite, which is taking care of the ingesting of the content, tagging.
Yes.
So all of that is happening, the identity. And then at the edge of the network, we have all of these different endpoints, whether it be gaming platforms, mobile tablets, all these new tablets that are coming out.
Yes.
We will have a software client for all of these different devices. So it really gives you, as the consumer, the ability to choose what your platform is.
And it also gives tremendous flexibility to the media generating of the applications to say, how do they share in the revenues? How do they
that's
partner
right.
with service providers? How do they stay close to their customers?
That's right. And as an end user, you know, I don't have to have three different subscriptions now. I don't have to subscribe to a movie service and a download service and get a special box. It all comes back together with the existing content that I already get through my premium television provider.
Now, how many of those do you have today in your home?
I have about five different ways of getting content today. And there's no way to search across all of those.
And then to share it easily.
That's right.
And you're pretty good at
that. You literally have to log in to five different places to be able to do that.
Now, as you think about this, you say, well, the network's just kind of in the background making this happen with dumb pipes. This is where service providers and Cisco work uniquely together.
That's right.
It's everything from the access points with the ASR 9000s and the 5000s that allows you to do this
that's
wirelessly
right.
with video. The capability to bring out a high-end router that does a billion in videos.
Absolutely.
And most people thought that was like the voice of old when people said we brought out a high-end router 8 years ago to do a billion voice calls.
That's
people
right.
said you might sell 100 of them. We sold 5,000 of them to 500 customers. It is the architecture for this, and you've got to have a security strategy that goes across each of these elements, where your ASIC strategy ties to your software, ties to your hardware.
Security, policy, identity, all of that.
Jim, I got it. And
thank
that's a great chart. Well done.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
All right.